Okay, example 6. I see that by the form that we're going to have to factor into two trinomials, the x squared could be split up into x and x because x times x is x squared. Then I move to the last number and think of what numbers multiply together to get negative 33. So I think negative 1 times 33, or 1 times a negative 33, 3 times a negative 11, or a negative 3 times a positive 11. So I want to get positive 8, and it looks like these two would add together to get a positive 8. So I would write a minus 3 and a plus 11. I could check myself by multiplying. X times x is x squared. X times 11 is 11x. Negative 3 times x is a negative 3x. And a negative 3 times a positive 11 is a negative 33, which simplifies to the same thing that I started with. So this would be my polynomial in factored form. So, example 7. A farmer plants a rectangular pumpkin patch. So this would be my rectangular pumpkin patch. In the northeast corner of this square plot of land. This is a square. I don't seem to know how large it is. It says the area of the pumpkin patch is 600 square meters. So this length times this width is 600. So then I can take however big this is. It's S. Is the whole thing, but if I took off 40, it would equal the length. So I'm going to say S minus 40 times the width, so it looks like S minus 30 is equal to 600. So I know that I can only solve a polynomial if it's in factored form, which this is. And I can only do that when I have the zero product property. But I don't have a zero right here. So I'm actually going to have to multiply this. S times S is S squared. Minus 30S. Minus 40S. Whoopsie. And then negative 40 times a negative 30 is a positive 1200. And then I need to make this side equal zero. So to do that, I'd have to subtract 600 from both sides, and I'm going to subtract it right here. It's like term. So now I have the zero, which means I can use the zero product property, and I have a polynomial on this side. I'm going to go ahead and combine those like terms. Negative 70s plus 600. But this has to be in factored form. So I have to think of what are two numbers that multiply together to get 600 that add together to get a negative 70. I can go ahead and split up my S's and think of these. I could have some easy ones to think of are 2 and 300, 1 and 600, 3 and 200, 4 and 150, 5 would be 120, 6 would be 100. There's going to be a really long list here. I actually can see, though, 60 and 10 multiply together to get 600. They add together to get 70. I need a negative 70, so I'm going to make that a negative 60 and negative 10. So those two multiply together to get 600, but add together to get negative 70. So these are my two, and I'm going to do minus 10. Minus 60. That means that S, or the length of this, could equal 10 for this factor, or it could equal 60. So I want to look at which one of those would make the most sense. It has to be something that I could subtract 40 from, so it's got to be bigger than 40, it's got to be bigger than 30. So I see that S must equal 60. This one wouldn't make sense. The question question asks me, what is the area of this square plot of land? So if S is 60, that means that this is 60. So 60 times 60 would equal 3,600. So the area of my farm is 3,600 square meters, it looks like. And got a few more problems for you to factor. Then, what if the area of the pumpkin patch was 200 instead of 600? So I'm going to give you that picture right here. For you to pause and do.